truck and we come back in with equipment, we smell what we think is the smell of ozone coming off of the material that comes back inside. So burnt wire or burnt metallic smell. But that's really only something we notice when we first come in from a spacewalk from being out in the vacuum of space. Internally, we got all kinds of smells in here, and a lot of it's related to food, some of it's related to hygiene. Some of it's related to our gym clothes that are drying out to try to reclaim the water and humidity that's in them so we can actually drink that stuff eventually once it goes through the processor. There's a lot of smells up here, and we really do our best to try to control those things. We clean every weekend. We wipe down the surfaces all over the space station in order to keep down the bacteria and mold from growing, which we really don't have much of, but I think it's because we're so vigilant about keeping the place clean.
How fast are you traveling? Like, how fast is the ISS moving?
How fast have you gone in a car?
Hey, man, hold on. Listen, probably 55 miles per hour. 55 is the fastest I've ever been in an automobile.
55. I can't drive 55, Will. That's just the way it goes, man. But right now we're doing about 17,500 miles an hour.
So you're circling at 17.5, right? So that means, so how many sunrises and sunsets do you see in the course of a day?
Yeah, we pick up 16 sunrises and sunsets. It takes me an hour and a half to get around the planet once.
Wow. So in that, I've heard a thing, you know, I'm doing the One Strange Rock, so I've heard of a thing called the overview effect. Have you experienced that? A couple of the astronauts on the show were talking about the overview effect, that when you go and you look back... on the Earth, it has a an effect on you. Can you talk about that?
And I think that it has that effect on everybody. Some people would really think that as an astronaut, when you look at the planet, it changes your perspective, and I think there are very few astronauts that wouldn't say that we wish that every human being could see with their eyes, not just pictures, but with their own eyes, what the Earth looked like from space. And I personally think it would change us as a species. It would change us and make us all realize that Earth is really a spaceship, and we're living on a spaceship with just a thin shell that keeps us safe from the vacuum and darkness of space.
When you look back, what is the shape of the spaceship called Earth?
It's pretty darn round from my viewpoint, and there's no doubt about it. We're going round and round.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that was one of those questions I X'd out from my comment. I refuse to ask that question. So we have about 2 minutes left. So I just really want to say thank you for this. You know, when I was a child growing up, I was one of those kids. Oh, is that's the water. Wow.
I don't have the water, but that's candy coated chocolate inside of a ball spinning.
Wow. That is fantastic.
It's kind of cool. These things all coalesce and start wrapping around the side of the ball here.
Yeah. That is fantastic. So no, Drew, I just want to say...
there's a lot of neat stuff to see up here.
No, that is fantastic. Thank you very much for your time. Is there anybody, you have any family members, anybody you want to shout out? Somebody you want to say hi to? Oh, that's hard.
Luckily, I get to talk to my family just about every day. I just want to give a shout out to all the people watching and say thanks for tuning in. And it's always a pleasure to talk to folks on the ground. And we hope that people keep joining the adventure here and watching the great stuff, the great research we're doing up on the space station. We appreciate you dialing in to ask us some questions today, Will.
Hey, Drew, I appreciate you, man. Thank you very much for your service. God bless.
All
Good luck.
Thanks, sir. Take care.
All right, now.
Good night. Good morning. Good evening.